Hey friends, I'm out here in the workshop, just got done doing some stuff, and this is in no way a video that I plan on making this summer. If you've seen the thumbnail for this video, you saw an oil filter with metal shavings in it, and that unfortunately has come from the XT225. So I saw the oil shavings in it when I changed the oil. I decided to flush it out. Put fresh oil in it. I rode it a couple hundred miles one weekend with my buddies Tony and Bronson. Great riding video. That'll probably be coming up next week. I look forward to sharing that with you. And then I checked the oil again, and well, this is what happened. And here we go, hoping that it looks okay. Looking pretty good. Oh, I am relieved. I am so relieved. I thought it all looked good, but unfortunately, I looked closer. No, there were still metal shavings in it. And you really have two choices at that point. You can pretend there's not a problem, keep running it, and just see what happens, or you can find out where in the world that metal's coming from, because it certainly doesn't belong there, and metal loose in your engine is not going to do good things. Well, I decided to clean the bike up, pull the engine out, tear it down, and this is the current situation. The good news is the top end looks fine. Cam, piston, cylinder, all looks good. The problem, though, was very obvious. It's sixth gear. Sixth gear was about ready to let go. And believe me, the irony isn't lost on me that I've put so much praise on the sixth gear in this motorcycle, and that's what ends up being a problem. The problem really just seems to be isolated to this sixth gear and the shift fork. Unfortunately, when you have metal loose inside your engine, it makes bearings stiff. You really should go through and replace a lot of things. Right now, I've priced it all out. Bearings, sixth gear, shift fork, seals, go ahead and throw new rings in and all that stuff. It's gonna come out to around $500 with the cost of a new bearing puller. I don't wanna spend $500 on a bike that I had plan to try and coax to 20,000 miles, another 3,400 miles. But yet this is where we are. I don't know. I'm thinking about it. Should I cheap out? Should I just replace the couple of bearings, the gear, and the shift fork for around 225? Or should I go ahead, go through the whole thing, completely rebuild the thing, not knowing how long I'm going to hang on to the motorcycle? I don't know. I didn't want to make this decision, and I'm having a hard time making the decision, so let me know what you think. I do know that some of the parts would be on back order for at least another month. I'm going to miss a good chunk of the riding season this year, so it doesn't matter if I decide today or next week. Things like the shift fork and a couple of the bearings won't be available until the end of July anyway, and this is later in June. I guess the good news is that I do have my LT2 Enduro 100 project, and I'm going to be playing with that. So that's where my focus is going to be right now. Not the summer I expected, but happy and healthy, things could be worse. Hey, thanks for watching. Let's figure this out together. Tell me what you think, and please ride safe.